Hey, this is Presh Talwalkar. Consider the points 1, 1, and 2, 2. They can be connected by the straight line y equals x. Similarly, consider the points 1, 1, and 2, 7. They can be connected by the parabola y equals 2x squared minus 1. These are examples of connecting points with a polynomial that has integer coefficients. Now consider the points 1, 3, and 3, 2. Can you connect these points by a polynomial that has integer coefficients? That is, can you find an equation of the following form that passes through the two points where all of the coefficients are integers, meaning they are positive or negative whole numbers? If you can, find an equation that passes through these two points. If you cannot, prove why it's impossible to do so. Can you figure it out? Give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching the video for the solution. So it would seem you should be able to find a polynomial that passes through these two points because you're not restricted to the degree of the polynomial. However, that turns out to be not the case. It is actually impossible to find a polynomial with integer coefficients that passes through these two points. We can in fact prove this by contradiction. So let's suppose we have a solution. Because this solution passes through the point 1, 3, that means we can substitute y equals 3 and x equals 1. Since 1 raised to any power is equal to 1, this simplifies to be 3 is equal to the sum of the coefficients, and we know that each coefficient is an integer. So what we've proven is that the sum of these integer coefficients is 3, which is an odd number. We also know this solution would have to pass through the point 3, 2. So we can substitute y equals 2 and x equals 3. Now we have to simplify this a little bit. Consider the powers of 3. Since 3 is an odd number, and an odd number times an odd number is equal to another odd number, we can conclude that all powers of 3 are odd numbers. So that means 3 to the power of k is always an odd number. Furthermore, if the coefficient in a particular power is even, then that coefficient times 3 to the power of k will be an even number. This is because an even number times any number will be an even number. If, on the other hand, the coefficient is odd, then the coefficient multiplied by 3 to some power will also be an odd number, because an odd number times another odd number is an odd number. So we can conclude that 2 has the same evenness or oddness as the sum of the coefficients. We can write this in another form. We can say that 2 is congruent to the sum of the coefficients when considering modulo 2. And this implies that the sum of the coefficients would have to be an even number. So on the one hand, we have the sum of the coefficients being an even number, and on the other hand, we have the sum of the coefficients being an odd number. This is impossible. This is a contradiction to say the sum of the coefficients are both even and odd at the same time. Therefore, our assumption that we did find a solution is not correct, and thus there is no such polynomial that can pass through these two points with integer coefficients. Did you figure it out? Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I make videos on math and game theory. You can catch me on my blog, Mind Your Decisions, which you can follow on Facebook, Google+, and Patreon. You can catch me on social media at Presh Talwalkar. And if you like this video, please check out my books. There are links in the video description.